Hey there and welcome to Living in Durham Region with Rob. If you clicked on this video, I'm guessing it's because you're interested in learning more about Whitby, Ontario, more specifically, Port Whitby and Whitby Shores. Well, I've got great news for you. This video is going to cover everything from the location of Port Whitby, to the home types, to the demographics, to the schools and some things to do in the area. And to cap it all off, we're going to hop out into the car, go for a little driving tour through Port Whitby to give you a better sense of what it feels like to live in that area. Hello everybody, it's me, Robert Marsiglio, sales representative with Keller Williams Referred Urban, living out here in Durham Region. Before we get into the video, I want to remind you, if you have any questions about anything I go over in this neighborhood, about Whitby, about Durham Region, the GTA, and beyond, please don't hesitate to call me, text me, email me, whatever works best for you. All my information is in the description of this video, and I love helping people just like you move to and from and learn more about this great part of Ontario. Enough of that though, let's get into the video. First off, where is Port Whitby? So as the name implies, it is down here close to the shores of Lake Ontario. We are framed pretty much by Blair Street, we'll call it, all the way up to the 401 and down across down Lynn Creek to the lake as the southern border. Now about one third of all condo sales in Whitby happen in this area between the three towers at Watson and Victoria Street, being Charles and the two on Watson, as well as this little area a little further south on Gordon Street. There's a few low-rise buildings over here. And all the freehold sales that do happen, happen in this pocket south of Victoria Street, kind of bordered by Lynn Creek and the harbor. So the homes in the area were mostly built in the late 90s and early 2000s, but seen some more development in the late 2010s as well, including the condo buildings that we talked about down here on Gordon Street. The high-rise buildings on Watson and Charles Street were completed in the late 2000s, and the vast majority of the homes in this area are owner-occupied. Now, when you talk about demographics and what is the population like, in the homes, you're seeing a lot more young families, whereas the condo buildings have a little bit of an older population. If walking to school is important for you, you're going to want to be in the public system, not the Catholic system, because it's only one elementary school in the area, not even a high school. That's all north, more so closer to downtown Whitby, but Whitby Shores Public School services this neighborhood. When it comes to transportation, one thing that this neighborhood boasts as the only one in town is that it does have a yacht club. It also has a boat launch. So if you do have a boat, this is where you would do it. But what about getting to Toronto? Sure, you can hop on the boat and cruise Lake Ontario all the way down there, but let's be a little more realistic. What is the commute like on the highways as well as transit? You're very close to the 401 in this neighborhood, so it is a 46-minute drive. Again, that's at 11:15 on a Wednesday, so maybe it takes you a bit longer during the commute. Give yourself an extra 15 minutes on top of this time. You can also go toll roads. You don't have to drive all the way up to the 407 though. That is an hour drive at this point in time. In terms of transit, it is worth mentioning that the Whitby Go station is located in this neighborhood. So it'll take you anywhere from an hour and a half to an hour and 42 minutes to get down there via transit. This neighborhood is one of the athletic hubs of Whitby because of the Iroquois Park Sports Centre. And this facility has ice hockey, it's got lacrosse, it's got baseball, it's got softball, has a soccer field as well. If you are more into the soccer, right across Victoria Street, there are the Victoria Fields, which consists of two senior soccer fields and eight junior fields. Then you also have Portage Park right down in the Whitby Shores area, which is another one of the hardball diamonds in town. Then, of course, you have all the lake has to offer, including the yacht club, including the marina, including Iroquois Beach. Lastly, for grocery shopping, don't worry, you don't have to drive all the way into town. There is a metro located on Victoria Street, right in the neighborhood for you. But enough of the computer screen. Let's go hop in the car to take a little drive around Port Whitby and Whitby Shores to give you a better idea of what it feels like to live in the area. Thank you. There you have it, we are back in the office. I hope that this video has shed some light for you on the Port Whitby and Whitby Shores neighborhood of Whitby, Ontario. If it has, please make sure to like this video and subscribe to the channel, as I'll be covering more and more Durham Region neighborhoods every single week. Remember, if you have questions about this neighborhood, about Whitby, about Durham Region, the GTA, and beyond, please call me, text me, or email me, whatever is easiest for you. All the information is down in the description of this video. And I love helping people just like you learn more and move into and out of this great part of Ontario. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.